the Nordic Combined Team Event. Four-member team in two disciplines, ski jumping on the large hill, followed by a cross-country relay. This was Bernhard Gruber for Austria. The Austrians were the gold medalists in Turin, but Gruber was under pressure here. He'd seen Felix Gottfeld and David Kreiner produce modest jumps by their standards, and he was the last to go. But Gruber saved their blushes with a beautiful jump. 136 meters, good style as well. Johnny Spillane, the last of the American quartet, the individual silver medalist on the normal hill. In fact, three Americans have finished in the top six, and they've done very well in the previous year's World Championships too. So expectations were high. And Spillane keeping his shape and landing beyond the calculation line in the telemark position, making sure that Team USA were in medal contention. The other members, Brett Camerota, Todd Ludwig, and Bill Damon. 18s for style, a distance of 134 meters. And next to go, Finland. The flag held aloft, indicating virtually no wind, and this was Anssi Koivurunta, their last man on the in run. And an excellent jump from the young Finn. 136 meters. His teammate Jani Rinnanen had set them on their way with a breathtaking 138.5. Now Koivurunta consolidating their position. He'd been the top man the previous season, number one overall in the World Cup rankings, and he was still only 21. Good distance and good style marks as well. And good news for Finland. It meant that they would start the cross-country relay in the lead. Behind them, the United States would be second, just 2 seconds back. Austria, 36 seconds down. And then Japan, France, Germany, and Norway. The start of the relay, four team members and 5 kilometers for each of them. Rinnanen, the brilliant jumper, starting just 2 seconds ahead of Camerota around this tricky course. And the two of them sticking like glue. This was where all their hard work would pay off, the months and years of a training program that sought to maximize power and minimize muscle mass for the sport where a high strength to weight ratio was absolutely essential. Seven minutes into the race, and the chasing pack. Norway, Austria, France, Germany, coming up to the 5 kilometer mark. And at the first exchange, the next skiers to go, getting all set. In the lead, the United States had taken over from Finland as the snow began to fall heavily. And Camerota would hand over to Todd Ludwig, the holder of 2 individual world titles. But the race was still pretty tight as Rinnanen would touch Jaakko Tallas to send Finland on their way. The chasing pack had started more than half a minute behind the Finns and the Americans, but now they'd almost caught up. Austria were there, France, Norway, Japan and Germany, all tightly packed together. Germany with Timo Edelman next, and France with François Brault. But by halfway through this second leg, things had changed. At the front, the USA had been joined by Austria after a great surge from David Kreiner, powering up the hill. Behind them, Edelman for Germany. But Finland had disappeared back into 7th position. And Austria now moving into the lead. 21 minutes into the race, and it was still Austria ahead of the United States. The others beginning to slip back. Edelman in 3rd spot for Germany as they approach the 2nd exchange. And for the Americans, Todd Ludwig. He'd come out of retirement, as he put it, to hang some more hardware around his neck. But in the relay, he found that it was Austria's David Kreiner hanging around. And they would come in absolutely neck and neck. Ludwig handing on to Johnny Spillane, with the legendary Felix Gottwald going for Austria. Spillane, number 2, the silver medalist on the normal hill. And when those two had finished their leg, it was Gottfeld in the lead as they came to the 3rd and final exchange. Gottfeld had also come back from retirement specifically to add to his collection of 6 Olympic medals. So now, the last leg of the relay, and it was Bill Demong for the USA against Mario Stecher for Austria. Stecher, age 32, had stood on the World Cup podiums no fewer than 35 times, including the top step at Seefeld in Austria earlier in the season. And Bill Demong in the red hat, the reigning individual world champion on the large hill. 700 meters to go and the last uphill challenge. Now it was a case of both physical and mental strength. Who would put in a surge? Who would crack? And it was the American who decided to go for home. Bill Demong putting on the power, but Mario Stecher refusing to quit. Stecher sticking like glue and coming into the last downhill section, and that awkward sharp bend, the 29-year-old from Lake Placid in California still leading from Mario Stecher of Austria by just a couple of meters. But had Demong attacked too early? Stecher wasn't finished. Suddenly he released all his energy and powered away. This was the man who'd shared the triumph of the Austrian team at the Olympic Games 4 years earlier. Austria had won gold then. It hadn't looked good for them here in Vancouver after the ski jumping. They'd started the cross-country relay adrift by 36 seconds. But now they were snuffing out the American dream. And coming towards the finish line, Stecher stormed home. He could hardly see because of water in his goggles, but his teammates were there to tell him that he really had won. The United States would finish second, with Germany third. So it was joy for Stecher, Gruber, Greiner, and for Felix Gottfeld, who'd returned from retirement to become Austria's most successful Winter Olympian of all time, with his third gold medal and his 7th medal overall.